What's up everybody? So welcome to a kettlebell workout that I've developed for you guys at home, whether you're at the gym or whether you're outdoors and you have a kettlebell at hand. All you need is water, a towel, maybe a mat if you've got some hard surfaces on the floor, and one kettlebell. Now the kettlebell ranges, my recommendation would be 8 to 12 kilos ladies. If you've never used the kettlebell before, 8 kilos is a good recommendation to start on, and if you have used the kettlebell before, 12 kilos and onwards if you want to. Gentlemen, 16 to 20 kilos is always a good recommendation, but once again, if you've not used the kettlebell before and you don't feel comfortable with it, 12 to 16 kilos and 16 kilos onwards if you've used a kettlebell before. Okay, so once again, just make sure you got some water at hand, make sure you got a towel and a mat and one simple kettlebell. Before we get onto our kettlebell workout, we're gonna start off with very simply a mobility-based warm-up, okay? So we're gonna go 40 seconds on, 20 seconds off, and each exercise is designed to set you up for the kettlebell workout to allow you to get better range of motion and also to free up your body and get your body prepared to work hard, okay? So if you can just move your kettlebell to the right or to the left, it doesn't really matter. And we're gonna start our mobility drill in 4, 3, 2, 1. Bring your feet together. I'm gonna ask you to tip from your hips, touch your toes, and you're gonna walk out into a plank. This exercise here is called an inchworm, and we're gonna do it for 40 seconds. Try and keep your legs as straight as possible to encourage a little bit more stretching in those hamstrings. Okay, so as the stretch occurs in your legs, the back of your thighs, you can bend your knees if it's a little bit too much, but you want to get a little stretch in the back of those hamstrings, okay? So nice and smooth, just walk out into that plank. And we're going to go straight into mobility exercise number 2. And that is done in a plank position, so we're going to do 2 more. And then we're going to go straight into a plank position, and we're going to start off with what I call a gate opener, okay? Nice and smooth. You've got about 10 seconds more, guys. So let's do one more each. Big deep breath at the top. Stay in the plank position. Okay, drop your shoulders away from your ears. You're going to step your foot next to your hand, driving your knee past your elbow, and I want you to return. Okay, we're going to do this for about 30 seconds. It'll be nice this morning. First thing in the morning, sun is out. It's a beautiful day. And I'm going to be nice. Not that it's never cold or wet too much in Dubai, but I'm going to be nice because I feel like I'm in a good mood today. Alright, so you've got 10 more seconds. Keep that gate opener going. I actually want you to feel a little stretch in your hips. Around here should be a nice area that you're going to feel that stretch. And we're going to stand on our feet in 3, in 2, give me one more, guys. 1, and walk back up. Good. Alrighty, take your feet nice and wide. Take your toes out. And I want you to hit a squat. Elbows between your thighs, pushing your knees out in line with your toes, and I want you to stand up. Try and hit the squat for about 2 to 3 seconds, and try and open up your body as tall as possible. So if I stand to the side, you want to lower your bum straight down. Try to discourage any falling forward, yeah? We want to try and keep our body upright, and this is setting us up for the goblet squat. Alright, so we've got, I reckon, 2 more squats in us easily. And that should feel quite nice. Designer, as I said, she prepares to prepare you for the workout. Not to kick your ass, not yet. And relax. Feet come together. Take a long stride forward. Take your hands over your head. And try to push your hip forward if you can. I'll show you to the side. So you've got a better view in a second. But try and encourage the hip to go forward. And this extension through the spine. So as you feel that extension, try and look up, look away from the floor, look straight up to your fingers, and just encourage a little bit more proprioceptive feedback. It gets the brain working, and that encourages a little bit of balance throughout our body. Good. You've got 10 seconds remaining, guys, and our warm-up is over. Once again, the film will stop. And if for any reason you want to do another round of this, just repeat or replay this round on your TV, on your iPhone, on your laptop, whatever you're doing. Let's do one more. Stepping in and relax. Breather, okay? So if you want to repeat that again, you can. We're going to take literally about 30 to 40 seconds. And of course, film is going to stop. Get some water and let's get through the workout. Driving on my way out in the sunny, yeah. Dropping off the top because it's sunny, yeah.
Picking up my shawty cause she ready now. Where you wanna go around the globe, I'ma fly you out. Love will be like, please don't go away. Touching on your wings, that's how we vibe, oh yeah. Don't wait for tomorrow, baby, you're gonna be sorry. Just live your life, tonight we gonna party. Let's not waste no time.
We want to prepare ourselves technically for the exercises on the kettlebell, and that's really important. We can't go straight into something that maybe you're not too sure on, or maybe you've never done before. So let's go through that drill stage. Now we're going to blend it, so we're going to get a little bit more of a metabolic cost to this drill stage. So we're still going to get some body weight based drills in there just to elevate our heart rate, just to make sure that we're getting a little bit more bang for our buck, as I would call. Okay, so you can need your kettlebell for this round. Once again, mat is required because you are going to be going down into the floor into a plank position. So, grabbing your kettlebell, we're going to go into a kettlebell deadlift, okay? So, two different parts of the kettlebell. You have the handles and you have the horns, okay? So those handles and the horns are going to be really, really simply the parts of the kettlebell you're going to grab for this block, okay? So, grabbing the kettlebell by the handle, which is the top part of the kettlebell, I want you to roll your shoulders back. Pull your belly in, so brace your core. Feet are going to be set up about shoulder width apart. And then all we're going to do is we're going to bend from the hips, or tip from the hips, keeping the knees bent slightly, and we're going to take the kettlebell down between our feet and then back up. Now, we're going to do this for about 30 seconds in 4, in 3, in 2, in 1. When you're ready, start. And I want you to think about pushing your bum back. Try and tip over your toes, so your chest goes over your toes. And you should be feeling a little stretch through the hamstrings. Yeah, so the tip is here, back is staying tight, core is staying on, and just notice that I'm not hitting the floor. Yeah, so this deadlift for me is enough to get my hamstrings activated and working. And for any reason you can get to the floor, my advice would be just consider that you don't round through your shoulders or bend through your knees. You want to get the work in your hamstrings, okay? So we've got 10 seconds more. Keep this going. Let the kettlebell dictate your pull down to the ground. The gravity's pulling us down. And 3, 2, 1, relax. Okay, so kettlebell's gonna go to the floor. Very simply, we're gonna take our feet nice and wide, and we're gonna turn the toes out, and we're gonna squat down. Taking your hands to the bell itself, you're gonna rotate once, rotate twice, and stand back up. In 3, 2, 1, let's go. So, touching the actual bell itself, which is the weight of the kettlebell, lower yourself down into that squat position, turning the knees and the toes out, and trying to keep the posture as tall as possible. Good, I'm gonna move back because I can't see my timer right now. Let's just move back slightly. There we go, I can see it now. 15 seconds, guys. There we go, cheater. You did one there, John. You need to be doing two. There we go. I hear you at home. 10 seconds. I hear you at home, I know what you're saying at the season. Probably calling me naughty language, using naughty language. That's it, so we're gonna do this last one. Stand up. Brilliant, great work. So, grabbing the kettlebell by the horn, okay? Pick the kettlebell up by the handle first, take your hands to the horns. Kettlebell's gonna go in line with the chest, toes are gonna be out, and we're gonna go straight into a squat. Lower yourself down, bring yourself back up, and then squeeze at the top, okay? In 3, 2, 1, wait. So this is called a goblet squat. The workout that we're gonna be doing, excuse me, does include this squat. So I want you to drill it first to get the idea of, one, the intensity of it, because you should be feeling your upper body and your core, lower body of course. But two, it's all about making sure execution is on point. Because remember, it's not about doing things that are going to damage us, it's about doing things efficiently that's going to get us results. 4, 3, 2, 1, stand up. Lose the bell, and we're going to go down into a plank position. All right, final drill, feet go wide, core is on, you know what's coming, John's favourite, touch opposite shoulder. I apologise if I touch my mic, but just touch your shoulder. Keeping your core strong, squeeze your butt cheeks and try and drop the shoulders away from your elbows as well as away from your ears. Okay, so pulling them down and back. Yeah, if they're lining up with your elbows, that's okay, but try and drop them back as much as possible. And once you drop them back, try and squeeze your back. There we go. Keep going. 5 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Relax. Good. Take a breather. Get yourself some water once again. If you want to repeat that drill stage, all you got to do is return back to the video and you get another set. It's easy as that. And once again, if you're good, we're going to go straight into the workout. Get water, got about 30 to 40 seconds.
Come up to meet you, tell you I'm sorry. You don't know how lovely you are. I had to find you, tell you I need you, tell you I set you apart.
Okay, so block one, which was our drill round, has now been completed. You may have done one or two rounds. Remember, that's totally up to you. Remember, that's totally up to your intensity as well. If you want to do a little bit more work today, do those two rounds together. And if you're a little bit of a rush or you want a bit of an express style workout, do that one round by itself, okay? So just to give you the heads up, this block that we're doing now is our workout round, okay? We are doing two rounds, ideally with no break in between. Once again, if you're coming to get a little bit more out of your workout on this video, you can do this round twice, which will make up four blocks or four sets, okay? So guys, what we're gonna be doing is we're gonna run through four exercises using the kettlebell, okay? So exercise one is our kettlebell swing. We did the deadlift at the drill round. The swing is very similar, but it's a little bit more dynamic and it creates a little bit more of a metabolic cost to get your heart rate up as well as you're getting your burning calories, okay? We're gonna be doing the swing, just checking my timer's on, for 30 seconds. Once again, the 30 seconds should be tough. It should not be easy, okay? So grabbing the kettlebell by the handle, we're gonna go tipping from the hips, taking the kettlebell between our legs. And let me just show you one rep so you get an idea. Picking the kettlebell up, keep your back nice and tight, take the kettlebell between your legs, through your legs, and we're gonna go into this swing, okay? I'm gonna face this direction so you guys can see my posture and I can see the timer. In 3, 2, 1, pick the kettlebell up and start the swing. So, kettlebell is going between my legs, and of course, the knees are slightly bent. They're not bending because that would be a squat. Notice my breathing. In, out, in, out, in, out. Good. Well done, guys. Back tight. All right, now, you're gonna notice my talking is very minimal on this set, for me anyway. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, time. Woo. Okay, take 15 seconds. Awesome job, guys. All right, we've got a little bit more than 30 seconds. Heart rate should be up, so big deep breaths. Grabbing the kettlebell by the horns this time. You're gonna pick the kettlebell up, elbows under. And you're gonna give me a military press, okay? So core tight, glutes tight, and go straight into that military press. Now, as the kettlebell goes over your head, try and think about keeping your biceps as close to your ears as possible on the press. Now, this is rep-based, so we're doing 12, and you've got four more. Hopefully, you've got my count right. Three more. Put it together, though. Two more. And one more. Keep the grip, take your feet wide, and give me 10 squats together. Core tight, glutes tight. Down and up. Down and up, that's two. Good, 3, 4, good. Upper body versus lower body. 5, 6, 7, grind them out. 8, 9, and 10, kettlebell down. Okay, big group breath. So, I'm now gonna give you 15 seconds, and we're gonna repeat that. 30 seconds of swings. Remember, a ballistic exercise. High intensity, if you wanna call it high intensity. Submaximal load. We're going in 5, 4, three, two, and one. Let's go. Into your swing, guys. Come on. Grind it out. We've got 15 seconds. Five things. Four. Three, two, one. Bell down. Grab your breather. 15 seconds, guys. Well done. All right, so we're going to go straight into that military press, okay? Catch your breath. That's what it's all about. Creating a high demand on the body and then targeting a little bit of a strength protocol. 5 seconds. Military press. Ready? Bell up. Grab it. Brace and press. So remember, we're doing this for reps. 12 to do. So that's 3. That's 4. I know you're impressed, right? 5. A trainer that can actually count. 6. That's on a good day. 7. 8. Well done. 9. 10. Don't stop. Don't stop. Go straight into our squat. Ready? Set. Wide with your feet and squat. Down, up. Down, up. Well done. Notice the knees and the toes are out. It's a wider squat. Good. That's halfway, yeah? Let's do 5 more. 5. 4. 3. 2. 1 more. Make it big. Yes, nice work. Relax. All right, 30 seconds, and then we're gonna go into round 2. Workout number 2 is complete. We're going to go into workout number 3. Now, a lot of you are saying to you, "Why, John, why are you calling it workout? Workout 1, workout 2, workout 3. So this is quite simple, because the beauty behind this block is that if you've got little time, you can do 1 workout and repeat maybe 3 rounds, 2 workouts, 2 and 2, which will make 4, or you can do all 3. Remember, it's entirely up to you. The idea of this is to fit into your life, however schedules would look or however time restricted you are, it's totally cool, okay? I'm giving you a full workout, but remember, you can break this down into micro sections if you want to, okay, guys? So, workout number 3, we're gonna be using the kettlebell, but we're also gonna be integrating our core, because at the end, I've saved a little bit for you for your abs, okay? I know, you can thank me later. So, exercise 1, workout 3, we've got 4 exercises, and what number 1 looks like this. It's a single arm row. Split stance position, let me show you how it goes. 5 on each arm. Left foot forward, kettlebell next to your foot, right foot back, forearm, left forearm to your left thigh, back tight, and what you're gonna do is you're gonna pull the kettlebell up in towards your armpit, your rib cage area, okay? So back tight, give me 5 reps. In 3, 2, 1, pull, return, 1. 2, 3, 4, and 5. Bell down, switch feet, repeat. 3, 2, 1, and away you go. Like my rhyme, huh? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Repeat that set. So you can see what I'm doing here. A little bit harder on workout 3. 5 reps on the right arm. 3, 2, 1, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Change. Step. Change. 3, 2, 1, go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bell down. Good. 20 reps of a pull, okay? Grabbing the kettlebell by the horns. pick the bell up, grab it by the horns. Reverse lunge, okay, so elbows under, step back, step forward in 3, 2, 1. 10 to do, guys. 1. So keep your core tight, body upward, upward, or upright, come on, get my English right, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10, kettlebell down, big deep breath. So, straight away we've done 30 repetitions, one limb is a little higher, kettlebell, you're going to grab by the handle. And you're going to give me a pull using an upright row. It looks like this. You're going to squat, elbows out, and drop, okay? 10 to do. 3, 2, 1, begin. 1, 2, do it quicker than we did before. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Kettlebell down, breathe. One more exercise. So as we recover, big deep breaths. Big deep breaths. We're going to do that same concept, but this time we're going to do a clean, catch, and press. Hands go from the handle to the horns, and then overhead. 10 to do. 3, 2, 1. Watch me. Catch. And go, guys. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Big deep breaths. So one set done, one set left. Single arm row, you ready? Left foot next to the bell. 5, 4, 3, 5 to do. 2, 1, begin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Switch. Away you go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Switch. There you go. Second block. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Switch. And again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Big deep breath. Stand up. Reverse lunge. Grab the bell. By the horns. 3, 2, 1, and away you go. Step back, step forward. Keep your weight stacked onto that front leg. Open up your chest and breathe as you move, remember. 6, 8, 9, and 10. Well done. Squat to high pull, okay? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good. Breathe, recover. Squat, catch, and press, okay? Up to you how hard you make it. You do it a little bit quicker if you want to. 3, 2, 1, begin, guys. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, nearly there. 8, 9, 10. Down, rest, recover. That was hard, right? Okay, grab some water. We got some core work to do. Okay guys, so had a little bit of a breather, had a little bit of a little rest, I'd like to think. If you're tired of your kettlebell, you can give it a little kick. I'm only joking, don't kick it because it hurts your toe. But we are going to use it within this block of core work that we're going to be doing. But the good news is, we're not going to pick it up. You've done enough of that now. We're just going to use it as a reference point to touch for our plank touches, okay? So, with your kettlebell, just move it slightly over to the left or to the right, doesn't really matter. And you're going to find a seated position on the floor. So, rep base still, we're going to be focusing on our core, and exercise one looks like this. I'm just going to slide off to an angle, so hopefully you can see me in that camera, but very simply, we're going to lay ourselves back, hovering off of the floor, and we're going to do very, very simply, hands to shins, 10 times, okay? It looks like this. You're going to go one, pause, return, okay? In three, two, one, let's go. So you're going to go one, return, two, three, four, not overly hard, five, six, wait, two, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Okay, take a breather. What I want you to do now is I want you to lay yourself back now. And you're gonna take hand to shin. One, two, three, four, opposite sides, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Sit up. Kettlebell, very simply, I want you to face it. Now, as you face it, make sure you've got an arm distance apart from you and the kettlebell. Go into a plank position and you're going to give me 10 taps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Okay, drop down to the floor straight away and let's repeat it. This time, 8 repetitions, advanced movement. Lay back or catch your knees. 3, 2, 1, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, we're going to go for 8, 6, 7, 8. Time. Opposite hand, opposite shin. 8 to do. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Hop yourself up. Plank position. Arm length away from the kettlebell. 3, 2, 1, tap. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Down to the ground. 6 reps, please. 3, 2, 1, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, burning, right, 5, 6, set up, opposite hands, opposite shin, 3, 2, 1, go, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, plank, remember arms length away, reach as far into the kettlebell as you can. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You've got 4 and 2 to do, okay? Let's do it without stopping. 3, 2, 1, go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Touch. 1, 2, 3, 4. Touch the bell. 3, 2, 1, go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Catch knees. 3, 2, 1, 2. 1, 2. Touch. 1, 2. Hop up. Plank. Touch. 1, 2. Finish. A little bit of a ladder. My core is burning. But remember, if that was not enough for you, you can do another round. That's totally fine. Okay? So, we're going to go into some stretching, so stay with me for about 2 more minutes, just to stretch. Well done, everybody. Okay guys, so for those who have just finished completing the kettlebell workout, we're about to move into 2-3 minutes of mobility. So if you've just followed me on YouTube and you've just completed the kettlebell workout, this is 2-3 minutes just to allow your heart rate to come down. For those that are following this block on Instagram, this is purely just to allow your body just to move, and like I said, you can use it in a way which sets you up for a workout or potentially brings you down from a workout. I'm very well aware that there's lots of workouts on Instagram at the moment that are flowing through Insta Lives. So if you want to use this just to plug into the end of your workout, feel free to. Please recognize this is not yoga, so shout out to my yogis out there. This is not yoga, and of course there's lots of yoga workouts out there on Instagram, on YouTube, check them out. Massive shout out to my Crank Stretch crew, as well as the yogis that I know in the market. Omar from the UK, big shout out to you, mate. I haven't seen you for a while. So, just about to go in through this mobility phase. Just join me down on the ground, please, guys. So, very, very simply, we're just gonna sit our hips to the ground. Remember, if you've got a mat, use that mat. The surface can be pretty hard on your knees. And of course, plank position, we're gonna drop our hips down to the ground. And we're just gonna look up to the ceiling or the sky, in my case. Just get a little stretch through those hips. Please remember, this is just a little bit of mobility, a little bit of stretching, and if you want to wiggle your hips from side to side, you can. I apologize, there's lots of flies. I clearly smell quite badly at the moment. So as you're wiggling your hips from side to side, relax your shoulders, big deep breaths in, breathe out as you rock those hips from side to side. And you're going to sit your weight back into your heels, lengthen your arms. What I want you to do right here is just to take your hand underneath that opposite arm and just take a reach through your armpit. That's it. And we're going to change sides in 3, 2, 1. Reach through. Get a little stretch. And just breathe. Remember, you can use this at the end of a workout, beginning of a workout, it doesn't matter. Or just literally getting out of bed just to get your body moving. There we go. Look back up. Try and reach that a little bit further. Just bring your heart rate down by taking a few big deep breaths in and breathe out. Shift your weight back. Weight into your heels. Get long through your spine. Take a reach through. Hold it for about 5 to 10 seconds. Remember, my rule of stretching, change sides. If it feels good, do it a little bit more, okay? So just hold it for a little longer. You don't have to follow me. If you want to catch me up, you can. And if it feels good, do more of it. It would be my biggest advice. Cool. Jump yourself up. Drop down into a squat position. You can take your feet as wide as they feel comfortable. Try and drop into the squat and push your elbows just slightly, creating a little bit more stretch in your hips and just getting your knees to align with your toes. Take your hands to the ground. Open up your chest. And what you're going to do is you're just going to reach up and rotate. Return back down, and remember once again, if you want to do a little bit more of it, do some more. It's totally cool. And for any reason this doesn't feel good, sit up a little higher, or don't do it at all. It's totally fine with me. Stand yourself up. Very simply, taking 1 foot forward, bend forward, try and keep the leg as straight as possible, and then we're going to change. Now we are going to go down onto the ground. We're going to go into what's called a 90-90 stretch. Okay, so dropping down the booty, and just get the hamstrings prepped for a little bit more, a deeper stretch. Inside of the foot goes into the inside of the thigh. Hop the leg behind. And what I'd like you to do is try and lift your chest. We're going to reach towards the knee and over away from the knee. Okay, so opposite hand's going to come across. We're going to reach. So what you should feel is a stretch in your glutes. For those that want to release two hands and get long to the floor, you can. And if you can't feel it, just rotate away a little bit more, or to the opposite hand, of course. Return, drop down to the ground, forearms to the floor. And what we're doing is we're creating a little bit more of a stretch in different areas of the hip. External part of the hip, and that's really important because the external part of the hip, we've got different parts of the glutes, as the PTs out there will tell you, and it's important to understand that a hip moves in three-dimensional movement. It's a three-dimensional piece of the body, so it's important to move and stretch that way. Oh, there we go. So there we go. Get my bearings right. There we go. So open up the body nice and tall once again. Reach the opposite hand through. And what you might feel is a little stretch right up here. Yeah. So that connective tissue. Moving into that lumbar section or that lower back area of your spine. Once again, if you want to reach further, reach further. Reach forward, press the forearms down. And if you can get flat to the floor, congratulations. If you're like me and you're really mobile, this is enough, right? This is totally cool. Awesome. Okay, sit yourself up. Take one foot forward, one foot back. So I'm going to take my left foot forward just so you guys can see what goes on with this hip. Push the hip forward. Open up through the spine. Look up to the ceiling. Naturally, there's a stretch right here, hopefully. Excuse me. And if there's not, don't worry. The hand's going to come up. And we're just going to pull the elbow back. That's really important to understand that the head is not moving. You're moving from this portion of your hip. Here we go. Good. Lateral stretch. Take that same hand, reach up and over. Remember, a little bit of a mobility wad for you guys as you wake up. I'm going to be putting on Instagram in the next 2 to 3 days, changing over. Just something that you guys can do for 10 minutes. Hip forward. And of course, if you're getting up out of bed, I've gone from, you know, my background is martial arts. Shout out to Mr. Jason Woodham. Not missing your swearing, by the way, mate. and for me, I train every single day, teach every single day on a bike. Shout out to my Crank crew. Shout out to Crank. Missing you guys, or everybody at Cranko at the moment. So I've gone from, in this quarantine stage, or when the studio's been closed, from teaching, you know, every single day to doing very minimal now. So I'm waking up in the morning a bit stiff, and that's totally cool. It's part of life, unfortunately, whether you like it or not. Feet are going to come together, tipping from the hips, getting a stretch in those hamstrings. Now touching the toes, you can see that for me ankle is good. I want you to bend your knees, catch your toes and straighten. Now we're going to just release the hamstrings. Neurologically, it's important by reaching up and looking up at the ceiling. Neurologically, it's important just to allow the hamstrings to come back down. If you force them to stretch, your brain is going to put the brakes on. Shout out to Ollie Thompson, teaching me everything I know about neuroscience, neurotraining. Put your hands up, lean away. We'll do one more. Shout out to everybody in the UK, Mr. Rory Palmer, Mr. Brad Bernal, everybody, all my friends in the UK. Shout out to Mr. Scott Island in Australia. I hope you guys are safe. Shout out to my family, my mum and my dad. This is like I won the Oscars. All right, so last time, feet go wide, toes out. Take your opposite hand to your opposite toe. Just get a little bit of a flow. And if you feel that you want to, start to rotate into the inside of your shin, inside of your thigh. Breathe, recover. Guys, feet together, take a breather. Well done. If you've just completed the kettlebell workout, congratulations. And if you've just done that mobility block, congratulations as well. Follow my YouTube page, there's lots of workouts on there. And keep an eye out for my Instagram, there's going to be more workouts available. Well done, everybody.